guys, it's day four of Concrete and Cranes. I'm getting a little nervous because tomorrow will be our last day, but let's not think about that right now. Let's just have fun. So today, as we continue on learning how Jesus is our strong foundation, today we're going to learn that Jesus will always be with me. Will you say that with me? Jesus will always be with me. So we are going to look at our verse together. Moms and dads, kids, everybody, there's a number below that you can call in. We want to see videos of your crafts, your playtime, everything you're doing with VBS. We want to see you so that we can share it with others and have a great VBS community. But let's look at our verse. How many of you are learning it? Raise your hand. I want to know. Here we go. I am sure of this, that he who started a good work in you will carry it on to completion until the day of Christ Jesus. Philippians 1:6. So let's say it one more time together. You know what? Say it loud. Bother your neighbors. Maybe they'll hear you screaming it in your neighborhood. That would be really fun. So here we go. I am sure of this, that he who started a good work in you will carry it on to completion until the day of Christ Jesus. Philippians 1:6. All right, well, today is a great day. Today, you're going to hear from Mr. Rusty, our fifth grade teacher. So you are going to hear that Jesus is always with me. I think you're going to enjoy your time with him. So let's get ready to pray. Let's close our eyes, bow our heads, hands in our lap, and let's get quiet as we pray. Father, what a great week we've had here at Concrete and Cranes. I just pray for each boy and girl that are watching, who have invited friends, who are just having a great time doing their crafts and everything together. Thank you for the special time that you've allowed for us. We just want to learn so much today that we know that you're always with us, and what an awesome promise that is that you give us. We just thank you, we praise you, in Jesus' name, amen. All right. Let's go see Renzo. I don't know what he's up to today, but I'm sure it's going to be interesting. Let's take a look.
Weeks pass quickly, and Renzo Wright has learned many things he thought he already knew. But Foreman Nehemiah and the Cobra Comb Construction Company continue to pull ahead. Things look hopeless for young Renzo. If he doesn't win, he will lose his reward, the use of the 34th floor.
Lloyd, I know sometimes I get mad, but you've always been like a brother to me.
Really?
That's why beating Cobra Comb has been so important to me. If we win, Mrs. Kuhlhaas said we could designate the 34th floor for a new kids' colossal Bible club, where kids all over the city could learn about God's love like we did. That's what my secret floor was for. But now I don't think it will happen.
Renzo, that's the nicest thing anyone's ever failed to do for me.
It's not over yet, Lloyd.
It's over, Renzo. Pack it up and go home.
I'm afraid he's right, Renzo. It's time to pack it in.
We can't give up yet, Mr. Santiago.
Yeah, think of the children.
It's not up to me. We've run out of gutters.
Hey, genius! Check your math next time!
Mr. Santiago, that's impossible! I ordered extra! More than we needed!
Sorry, kid. It's true.
Oh, man! Things can't get any worse.
We're out of concrete, too.
Well, that's worse.
Looks like we put too much concrete and steel into the foundation.
What a waste!
It's okay to mess up, Renzo. I do it every day.
No, Lloyd. I did the right thing. There's no way I didn't order the right amount. I know it cost us a lot of time and materials, but to grow big, you have to build on a strong foundation.
You've come up short this time, Renzo. Literally.
Mrs. Kuhlhaas?
What's this I hear about running out of concrete and girders? Renzo, you said you would build the tallest building in the world, but you didn't even get the supply order right.
That's not actually...
Extra, extra, read all about it. Boy genius botches job, reevaluates his genius. Get your...
That paper boy is very dedicated to his job.
Mrs. Kuhlhaas, there's been a mistake.
Yes, there was, hiring you. I'm pulling your contract. You're no longer the chief architect. You're now assistant to the weekend intern. And don't expect to get your Bible club either.
Renzo, you lose!
Oh, God. I don't understand. I've never failed like this before. I did all the math. I was sure we had enough girders and concrete. I guess I really need your help. Truth is, I always have. It doesn't have to be the biggest building, Lord. Please, help us build the best building we can.
Even with all his smarts, the boy architect could not get everything right. But what's most important is that Renzo knew where to turn. Renzo remembered that Jesus had promised he will always love us, no matter what kind of trouble we get into. Jesus is our strongest foundation.
While we show you how to do the craft, we'd like you to wait until the end of VBS before you put it together. Welcome to Tool Time with Tool Time Ty. I'm Tool Time Ty, and it is now Tool Time. Heather, come on over.
Hi.
Hey, Miss Heather, thanks for visiting with us.
Thank you.
What do we have today? What do we have today?
Okay, so today, our craft, we're making a mirror.
A mirror?
A mirror.
A
and
mirror.
This mirror will remind me that Jesus will always be with me.
Oh, it's a lovely mirror.
And I can look in it and be reminded that Jesus will always be with me.
Jesus will always be with me. I like
yes,
that. So
yes.
Get out your circular saw again, kids. This time for real.
Oh, No, not for real.
Don't do that. That's a bad idea.
No.
Okay,
no.
If you insist, but I think it might be useful for this project. What do we need?
So what you will need is you'll need your pieces from your kit. You'll have your brown foam. Okay,
all right.
And then you'll have your little mirror page.
Got it. Got a mirror page there.
Yeah.
Oh, that's a paper mirror. That's interesting.
Isn't that cool?
Okay.
And you'll also have some stickers.
Ooh.
And some magnet pieces.
Okay,
Let's go ahead and take the magnet pieces.
Yes.
And we'll take them off.
Okay. All right, so just take them off of the paper here?
Off the paper, okay. Yeah. Peel them. There's
right.
Two magnets.
Two magnets, all right.
So you'll want to put one magnet toward the top and the other one kind of toward the bottom.
Okay, and at this point, it doesn't matter which side, does it?
No, it doesn't.
Choose the best side, kids.
Right.
I like this one.
Right.
All right. Do that there and that there.
Okay.
Okay, top and bottom, right?
Yes.
Top and bottom?
Top and bottom.
Ah.
And then you'll want to flip it over.
Ah.
And the mirror part. And next, you'll take your mirror part, and you'll go ahead and peel off the back.
Okay.
Okay, so you'll want to peel
that off right there, okay.
Yeah.
Very nice.
Take that piece off, and you'll want to put it kind of, not really in the middle, because you want a little bit of space for your writing.
Okay.
So you'll kind of put it kind of down a little bit.
Okay, not entirely at the top.
Right.
All right, kind of a little bit towards the bottom.
Towards the bottom.
Like that right
perfect.
There?
Perfect.
Is that good?
Perfect.
Okay.
And you
want to
press it down.
Press it down.
So it
okay,
sticks.
I'm going to do that. Very nice. There we
Very
go.
Very nice.
Okay.
And then you'll want to write at the top.
Yes.
And it says, Jesus will always love.
Oh.
...
Jesus will always love ellipses. Interesting.
Ellipses.
I like that. Okay, all right.
Yes.
All right.
Yes.
Jesus
will always love
but what's the answer? What's the end of the sentence?
Well, as you look in the mirror part,
yes.
You'll see that Jesus loves you.
Oh!
And if you share it with your friend, they'll see that Jesus loves them.
Oh my goodness.
Yes.
This is clever. Did you come up with this?
No.
You could have said yes. I don't believe you. All right. That's wonderful. Now, is there anything else that I'm supposed to do?
Okay, so now, it kind of looks kind of drab, so we need some more tools
nice,
around
but all right.
It.
Okay,
we
some,
want
tool.
Some tools.
Okay, okay.
Some tool stickers. So you have some tool stickers in your kit, and you'll want to peel them off and then place them where you would like them around your mirror.
Oh, because I like to put it at the bottom. I got a nut right here. It goes like that. There we are.
And we can remember that Jesus not only loves us, but he will always be with me.
Jesus will always be with
me wherever you go.
I like that one. Well, thank you very much.
Thank you.
Yes. This has been Tool Time with Tool Time Ty. This was Tool Time, but now it's not. Hey, this is Tool Time Ty. I'm here with Miss Jackie. Miss Jackie, what'd you bring for us today?
Hey, we've got another exciting day with the Worthy family in Italy. So remember to listen closely because we're going to ask you questions when we're done.
All right, well, let's take a look at it.
Hi, guys. Every morning at 7 a.m., our family does a family devotion before we head off to school. Our school is real close and we can walk there in like 5 minutes. School here is a lot like school in the U.S., except here we learn more languages because Italy is home to so many people from different countries.
Sono un cavallo fatto di legno.
I'm learning 3 languages, French, Latin, and Italian. In Italian, Jesus loves you is Gesù ti ama. Can you say that? Gesù ti ama.
Cosa facciamo domattina?
Si fa il lavoro di cavallo di Troia.
Oh, bravo!
School's another great place to tell people that Jesus loves them. Throughout the year, we host outreach parties at our house, where we invite a whole bunch of our friends from school to celebrate things like holidays and special events. And there we can tell them about Jesus.
In this area of Italy, it's where the story of Pinocchio was written. You know the story of the little wooden boy whose nose would grow every time he told a lie? You couldn't always trust what Pinocchio said, but we can always trust what God says.
In Matthew, Jesus says, "Therefore, go and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, of the Son, and the Holy Spirit. And remember, I am with you always, to the very end of the age."
Not only is that an awesome promise, but it's also a command for us. Go tell others about Jesus, and that's what we do.
And one way we do that is by hosting a really big VBS camp during the summer. It's a lot like VBS in the States, with games, activities, and a lot of stories about Jesus and how he loves us. VBS is so much fun, so remember God's promise. He will always be with you, and go tell others.
All right, Miss Jackie, that was some video. I have a question for the kids at home. What promise does Jesus make to us in Matthew 28:20? Oh, I heard a lot of good answers out there. Miss Jackie, why don't you tell us?
Well, he said, "I am with you always." That means you don't have to worry. He'll always be there.
Okay, I've got another question for you. If you were listening, you'll know what Gesù ti ama means. Oh, I think I heard the answer. Miss Jackie, why don't you tell us?
Hey, you speak Italian real well. It means Jesus loves you.
What can the kids at home do to help missionaries?
Today, our thing to do for missionaries is to volunteer. That means you can volunteer your time. However you want to do it, you can do it at church or somewhere else. You can volunteer and help missionaries.
Well, all right, Miss Jackie, thank you for coming out. This has been Tool Time Ty and Miss Jackie. Now on to the rest of Concrete and Cranes.
Hey kids, it's Mr. Rusty, and here at Concretes and Cranes, happy to be here with you guys. So I brought some tools with me from the job site, and just thought it'd be cool to bring them here. I got, of course, the circular saw. It's got a nice little blade here so I can cut my wood. Brought a drill, can put some screws into wood. I also, the most important tool that I brought is this pouch. I brought it because it's most important because it has everything that I need at, right at my hands. It's got my hammer. It's got a utility knife that I've got. Got a speed square. And it also has one of the most important things I carry with me every day. It's got my snacks. Can't work without my snacks. Everything that I need with me at all times. And that's an important thought because that's part of our lesson today. So we learned last lesson was that Christ died for us. He showed his love for us, his unconditional love for us, because he died for us on the cross. And we know that he was buried. And this lesson takes place right after that, where we start off with, there's two Marys. You know, how confusing is that? Mary and Mary, they're headed to the tomb where the Lord was laid. The stone is rolled away from the front entrance of the tomb. There's an angel saying, hey, don't worry. The Lord is not here anymore, but he is risen, just like he said. And they were scared, but excited at the same time. And the angel told them, hey, go to Galilee. You're going to see the Lord there and meet him with the disciples. So they rush off to see the Lord there. Before the Lord goes back up to heaven, he gives them this encouraging words from Matthew 28. It says, teaching them to observe all that I've commanded you, and behold, I am with you always to the end of the age. And that's a neat thought right there, that he is with us always. And just like my tool pouch, I got all my tools with me all the time, got my tape measure. If I don't have my pouch, I'm not going to have it with me. And that's the same thing here, the Lord's words to his disciples and to Mary and Mary, and also to us, is that he is with us always. In our classroom, we always talk about three different questions. The first one is, what does this teach us about God? And when I look at it, it teaches me about God's love for us, right? He is with us always, and we may not see him physically anymore, just like when he was with his disciples, but instead he has sent the Holy Spirit to be down here with us, and that is his love for us, and that he is with us always. Question two, what does that mean to you and me? Well, for me, it should give us boldness. It should give us that we don't have to fear. Acts 18, when the Apostle Paul was doing his ministry, the Lord told him, hey, fear not, for I'm with you always. And that same promise is true for me. It's true for all of you guys. Whenever circumstances you're in, whether it's just having a rough time with school, with doing school from home now, some of you guys that aren't used to doing that, hey, God is with you always, and he can help you with your schoolwork or whatever things you're going through these days. So God loves us. He's given us that promise, and our encouragement is that he is with us always. And the third thing is, who can I tell? Well, that's for you to decide, not me, but for me, it's people at work, with the people that I work with. But who's in your life? Who's in your life that you can tell about what God has done for you? Tell them about that God is with you at all times. Tell them about what God has done on the cross, and then what God's doing now, that he's with you at all times. So that's the encouragement devotion for today, is that God loves you, God is with you all the time, and because of that, you don't have to worry and you don't have to fear. Day four, don't forget to go to your little book here and do the lesson for today, the little kind of follow-up guide for the day four, the resurrection and the promise for Matthew 28. If there were things in the lesson today, if there were things in the lesson from the other devotions that we had, and you are interested more in hearing more about it, hearing more about what God's done for you, what he did on the cross, please text to the number below. And we'd be happy to have someone talk with you and your parents and discuss that more. Also, while you're doing your activities, while you're watching the videos and of Concretes and Cranes, and you're doing all the crazy stuff, all the activities, we'd love to see pictures. We'd love to see videos of you guys doing crazy stuff and enjoying your time. So share those as well. I think that's it. So have a good day.
Hey guys, it's the end of day four of Concrete and Cranes. Wasn't it a great time? And we learned today that Jesus is always with me. So you can get your green, I don't even know what these things are called, chip, and put it on your clip. So how many of you have your verse put on your clip? Don't put it on until you learn. So now, today, make sure you send in your pictures. We want to see what you're doing. We want to see your crafts. I want to see pictures of your crafts. I want to see if you did it right. So send those in, and we would love to share them with each other. So let's pray. Father, thank you for today. Thank you for Mr. Rusty's lesson. And we just thank you that we have such awesome leaders to lead our kids, Lord. We thank you for them. Be with each kid as they study and learn today and bring them back tomorrow safely. In Jesus' name, amen. All right, remember the music's there for you after the show today, and we will see you tomorrow at Concrete and Cranes.
Oh, hey, see you later. Oh, hey, goodbye, everybody.
Bye.
Oh, hey, guys. Hey, thanks for joining us today. We'll see you guys later.